Hello students, hope you all are doing good. In this video, I am going to discuss about the five conditions that needs to be satisfied for an amalgamation to be in the nature of merger. Now, before discussing about the five conditions, let me just brush up so far what we have discussed. We have discussed amalgamation of companies and the various terminologies associated with amalgamation. We have also discussed in my previous video the transferee accounting entries in the books of transferor company and transferee company. Now let me just repeat. Transferor company, if any of you have forgotten, is the company which is being sold. It is also known as the selling company. Okay, transferor company is the selling company, and transferee company is also called as purchasing company. That means in our example, AB Limited is considered to be the transferee company. That means AB Limited has purchased A Limited, and A Limited happens to be the transferor company. Now, if some of you are having some confusion regarding the terminologies here, transferee and transferor, I'll just share a small trick with you all so that you don't get confused. See, look at the word transferee. See, I have marked the word E here. I mean, I have marked the alphabet E here. And since transferee company is the new company, I just told that transferee company is the new company. And in the word new, you will find the alphabet E, right? So, in the word transferee also there is E at the second last alphabet. And in the word new also there is E. So, if you have confusion, EE, that means new, and then transferee. And regarding transferor, see, look at the second last alphabet of the transferor word. It is O, right? So in the word old also there is an alphabet O, right? So in case if you get confused, you try to remember it in that way. Okay, so I'll move now. See, in case of transferee company, accounting standard 14 has laid down the accounting treatment, the whole accounting treatment to be followed regarding transferee company. But accounting standard 14 has not laid down any such provisions or any such treatment to be followed for the transferor company. It is giving only for the transferee company. Now the standard has prescribed two methods which are to be followed while recording transaction. There are two methods which can be followed while recording transaction or while recording, while giving accounting treatment of the transferee company. These two methods are pooling of interest method, and the second method is purchase method. Okay. Whenever we are passing journal entry in the books of transferee company, we may pass journal entry in any of these two methods. Now the question is, when should we apply which method? That means when to apply which method. See, whenever amalgamation is in the nature of merger, we should apply pooling of interest method. As you can see in the left hand side, whenever amalgamation is in the nature of merger, we will be applying pooling of interest method for recording of the business transactions. On the other hand, whenever amalgamation is in the nature of purchase, we will be applying purchase method for recording all the business transactions. Is that clear? Now, the question is, how would you know whether amalgamation is in the nature of merger or whether amalgamation is in the nature of purchase? Because to apply the methods, you should at least have the understanding, a clear understanding that whether amalgamation is in the nature of merger or purchase. For that purpose, sometimes in your question, it might happen that it has been directly mentioned as to which method you should follow. In your question, it will be directly stated apply purchase method or apply pooling of interest method. In that case, you don't need to think much. You just apply whatever the question has asked you to do. You just solve the sum in the way question is asking you. Okay. Now, whenever the question is silent regarding the application of methods, okay, the question is not saying about which method, the question has not specified about the method that you will have to apply while recording the transaction, okay. In that case, what will you do? Herein comes the role of the five conditions. Okay. If in the question it is not mentioned whether you will be applying pooling of interest method or whether you will be applying purchase method, or they have not said whether it is in the nature of merger or whether it is in the nature of purchase, then you will have to see that whether these five conditions, the five conditions that I have written it over here, whether these five conditions related to merger has been satisfied or not. Okay, if these five conditions are satisfied, then you will be recording entries as amalgamation is in the nature of merger, and therefore you will be recording entries according to the method of pooling of interest method. Okay, now if any of these five condition is breached or any of these five condition is violated, you will straight away understand that amalgamation is in the nature of purchase, and hence you will apply purchase method while recording the various transactions in the books of transferee company, in our case it is AB Limited, or the new company, right? So now let's have a look at the conditions that needs to be satisfied. Okay, condition number one, what does it say? It says that all assets and liabilities are acquired. Okay, acquired means taken or purchased. Now you ask yourself a question here. Who will acquire? Let's look at an example. There are two companies, A Limited. The other company is AB Limited. Now, who is the purchasing company? Purchasing company will be acquiring the selling company, right? In our case, the purchasing company or the new company is AB Limited. AB Limited will be purchasing which company? A Limited. Okay. Remember, we are doing amalgamation. We are dealing with amalgamation in the nature of merger. So the first condition that all the liabilities and assets are to be acquired by AB Limited. Whose liabilities and assets? A Limited. That means the transferor company's liabilities and assets should be acquired by AB Limited. Now if in the question it is said that they have not acquired all the assets and liabilities, you will straight away understand that it is not amalgamation in the nature of merger, but it is in the nature of purchase, and hence you will give purchase method. You will treat accounting entries under purchase method. Now let's have a look at the second point. At book value. Now at what value will they acquire the asset and liabilities? They will be acquiring the asset and liabilities in the book value. Okay. It straight away says that it will be acquiring the asset and liabilities in the book value. And the meaning of book value means balance sheet value. Book value here indicates the balance sheet value. Whatever balance sheet value is given, they will be acquiring it the value of balance sheet. Okay, the next condition, condition number 3, same business should be carried on. Whose business? They are talking about the business to be carried on by A Limited. Say suppose A Limited had a business of making shoes. They are shoe producers and sellers. Okay, now even after AB Limited has taken A Limited, the same business of A Limited will be carried on by AB Limited. Okay, the same industry, same business. That means in the nature, when it's in the nature of merger, AB Limited, even though they have like taken over or even though they have like amalgamated, A Limited will be carrying on the same business. AB Limited will let A Limited carry on the same line of business. Now if they are not carrying on the same line of business, that means they are violating the condition, and therefore it will be considered as amalgamation in the nature of purchase. As simple as that. Now look at point number 4. It's very important. Shareholders of transferor company holding at least 90% of equity share capital should become equity shareholder of transferee company. Shareholders of transferor company. Look, in our case, who is the transferor company? A Limited. That means the shareholder of A Limited. Now, who is A Limited? A Limited is the transferor company or the selling company, the company which is going to get liquidated. Okay. Shareholders of transferor company who is holding not less than 90% of the share, who is holding at least 90% of the share of A Limited. That means those shareholders who are holding 90% of A Limited share will become the shareholders of transferee company also. That means they will, if they are holding 90% of shares at least, that means they will become the shareholders of AB Limited also. Okay. The next condition. Purchase consideration should be paid. PC means purchase consideration should be paid only in equity shares / preference share of transferee company. Now, what is purchase consideration? It is the consideration or it is the amount which the transferee company will be paying, because transferee company is the purchasing company. They have purchased transferee company, right? In our example, AB Limited is the transferee company. It is going to purchase, or it has purchased A Limited. Therefore, AB Limited will be paying A Limited. Okay, and then the amount is called purchase consideration. It should be paid only in equity shares or preference share. If they have paid in any other form, okay, if they have paid in any other form, it may be in the form of payment, in the form of other securities such as debentures, or it may be in the form of cash or bank. If they have paid in any other form, that means they have violated the conditions, and therefore it will be regarded as amalgamation in the nature of purchase. I hope you all have understood. Now, in some cases, it may happen that a fraction or a decimal, if it comes in a fraction or a decimal, that means the some of the shares, it may remain unpaid, right? A fraction of the share or decimal part of the share is still unpaid. In that case, cash payment is allowed. But other than that, they will have to pay only in the form of equity shares or preference share. If they are paying by any other means, that means they have violated the condition, and therefore it will not be regarded as amalgamation in the nature of merger. And therefore, if it is not in amalgamation in nature of merger, you will be considering it, you will be treating all the transaction under the purchase method. I hope all the points are clear, as simple as that. Point number one, I'm repeating again, all assets and liabilities are acquired at book value. It should be acquired at book value by the transferee company whose asset and liability, asset and liabilities belonging to the transferee company, and then the transferee company is allowed to carry on the same business. That means even though they have acquired, they will be carrying on the same business. And then the next one, transferee company shareholders who are holding at least 90%, they will become the equity shareholders of the new company, that means transferee company. Okay, and then PC would be paid in the form of equity shares or preference share, but not in any other form. If these five conditions are not satisfied, if any of these five conditions are not satisfied, you will understand that it is not in the nature of merger, it is in the nature of purchase, and hence you will give accounting treatment accordingly. So I hope you all have understood. If there is any doubt, you can comment on the comment box. Thank you.